Hello guys, welcome to another deck profile. Today we've got Blue Eyes with you with the new cards from Shining Victories as they got released this week. So quickly built it, thanks to the guys who helped me out building it. And still complete, need one more card, which is Twin Burst, which I do play but I don't have it at the moment, which I will mention at the end. But yeah, this deck, Blue Eyes got good support. It can now stop a couple of meta decks, so it's a good counter against them, and it speeds up the deck quite a bit. And this is the build that has Dragon Ravine because we don't have alternative yet, so at the moment I'm playing Malefic Blue Eyes as a substitute. It's not as good, but it's the best one we've got so at the moment because you need Blue Eyes to make this one. So without any further ado, let's go and start the deck profile. I'm very sorry about this, but I'm using the structure deck Blue Eyes. I'm using the pleb version basically, but we're playing free. Oh, Blue Eyes White Dragon, the vanilla is just really good. It's just a vanilla beat sticks 3k, biggest vanilla monster in the game. Crash into Dark Destroyer. Blah blah blah, good against the meta, can kill Dante, can kill Beatrice. And if you have this in your field, you can stop whatever they float into. So triple, and once again, I'm very sorry. I'm not using the awesome, like limited edition Blue Eyes. I know Craig's gonna be mad. Greg's mad at me using these, because this is like the pleb version. But if you're a big fan of Blue Eyes, you should be playing the best versions of Blue Eyes. Like maybe the vanilla Kyber one, or the cool ones. And there's some expensive ones as well that you can get. But yeah, three Blue Eyes definitely, because you do need three in the deck. And we only play two of the Dragon Spirit of White or White Blue Eyes White Card Dragon. We play two because sometimes they bottomless it and it's gone from the game. So the second one's quite useful. And we do dump the egg quite often, so the second one can come in and it banishes a back row on summon. Keep in mind, it can miss time, so if you do like a chain link two or more called Haunted or Silver's Cry, this will miss time and won't be able to banish your opponent's back row, so keep that in mind. And also, a very useful effect if your opponent tries to do something to it, like a 101 or Castell, which targets it, you can just tribute it and summon Blue Eyes in your hand. And having Blue Eyes in your hand is a very common occurrence in this deck, so it should be very easy to perform that play. We play one Cyberian Dragon, but it's a Malefic Blue Eyes White Dragon. Only play one because we only really summon once per game, because you need to banish a Blue Eyes from your deck to summon it from your hand, and you need to have a field spell Dragon Ravine in hand. You have to develop any kind of field spell to make it not die. And this card's just a level 8. You usually don't attack with this unless you only have this as the monster. But if you have the egg, the new egg from the grave, you can dump this with the Dragon Ravine, and then you can get the egg, banishing the egg, getting this card from your grave to your hand, and you can spec it, and then you can make a level 9 play or rank 8 play with the one Malefic Blue Eyes White Dragon. You just need one, and it's a level 8, and if you draw it, you don't have the field spell, it's kind of dead, so just one's good, and you can also trade it in, it's a level 8, so that's the only one. And of course, now we start with the new cards, Blue Eyes Sage. One of the best ones, best level 1 tuners in the game now. Normal summon it, search a level 1 light tuner from your deck. Most of the time it's going to be the new egg, but you can also search Effect Veiler, etc. or Maiden if you do play Maiden. And it's also got an effect on your hand, so what you do is to pitch it and target one of your effect monsters, and then special summon Blue Eyes from your deck. You can also summon this one from your deck because it discounts the Blue Eyes monster. It isn't restricted to just Blue Eyes White Dragon, so that works. And it's also level 1 tuner, and you know how good that is in this deck because you can make level 9 synchro. So definitely play 3 of this, and of course we play triple of the new egg. The end phase, you can special summon a Blue Eyes from your deck. Once again, similar to Sage, you can summon the Spirit Dragon or whatever Blue Eyes one or this one from your deck. Keep in mind, you can stack these, so if you send two of these in a turn, so for example you got Dragon Ravine and you have this in hand, you pitch this in hand, you send this to the grave, you can summon two Blue Eyes from your deck at the end phase. That effect's not once per turn. The once per turn effect is the graveyard effect, which is also excellent if you banish it and get a Blue Eyes monster from your grave. That's, as I mentioned, with the Malefic Blue Eyes White Dragon, you get into play, or you can just get the level 8 monster in your hand, so you got targets for trading, so your draw engine becomes live. Definitely play 3, one of the best cards in the deck, since it fixes dead hands. Only one old egg White Sword of Legend. It's just good dumping a Ravine if you've got undead trading in hand, since you can search the Blue Eyes. Not the best level 1 tuner, but it's really good for plussing. The problem with this card is, playing too much of it, is if you do dump it, or if you synchro it quite often, this will become then your deck, because the search for this for the blue ice white dragon is mandatory, and this card needs to banish the blue ice white dragon from your deck. So only play one. It's just good for fixing hands, because you've got trading and stuff. You can search the blue eyes and dump whatever if you want to pitch it with your discard fodders like Ravine. And of course we play one Dragoon T Corsica. I like this tech because we play Ravine, of course. Ravine can also search level 4 or lower Dragoon T monsters, so if you need a level 1 tuner, just pitch a card and then get a Dragoon T Corsica and normal summon it. It's the biggest one. There's also Branded Stock, but this was the biggest one, so it's 800 attack. That's literally the reason why we're playing it over Branded Stock. But just play one, because it's also a cards of concentration target, so if you've got a cards of concentration, you can search it off Ravine and then draw two cards. So just a good utility card, just a wonder will do. And one tech that I like putting in is Komodo Dragon. I don't like drawing it, but if you play it in the deck, you'll sometimes need it. If you go turn one, you got Ravine, or you just have Ravine, you can dump a Ravine and a Blue Ice in your hand, and you can just pitch this with Ravine from your hand or your deck and spec the Blue Ice from your hand. Then you can normal summon the level 1 tuner and probably make a level 9 synchro, or maybe even rank 8 if it's possible. You can also use Sage by normal summoning is attributing this, and then special Blue Ice from your deck, and then special one from your hand. It's like, if you don't like playing this though, you should play a Maiden instead. But I like using this because we play Ravine and it's a dragon target, and Maiden's not a dragon, so it doesn't work with the Ravine. The main problem with this is a restriction, is you can't do your battle phase in a turn, you can't spec anything else but dragons, so you can't make Felgrand, and you can't spec Sage, for example, from the Soul Charge or whatever, but you won't do it anyway. So just play one Komodo Dragon. It's very good for utility and stuff. So we just want Veiler, because sometimes we got a extra search with Sage, but Veiler's really weak right now in the meta, so just play one. If you've got a spare search, you may as well search the effect Veiler. So just search the one Veiler. It's not a Dragon Master, but you can also use it as a tuner if you need to. And of course, 2 Maxi, because it's just good right now. People specialize it all the time. You want to draw cards as well. So, but very dead. If your opponent's playing a deck that doesn't really specialize like your Senju, you can still pitch it with Dragon Ravine or whatever. So it's not really that bad drawing it. Of course, that's all the monsters. Quite a lot, actually. And of course, we play 2 Ravine, and I like playing triple terraforming because it's the main core of the engine. If you do get an extra terraforming like this, eventually your opponent would probably pop the Ravine, so I usually bluff set one of the terraforming and keep the one terraforming in hand. And even if it's in your hand instead, you can even pitch it with the Ravine anyway, so it's not much of a problem playing 3 terraformings. I don't know why this is at 2, it should be at 3 probably use balance, I've been mentioning it. So Ravine's effect is you just dump dragons once per turn in your deck. Also, it's not once per turn for the card, it's once per turn for the field. So if you've got 2 Ravines, you have ridiculous plays where you can just pitch 2 cards from your deck. Similar to Dragon Shrine. I don't play Dragon Shrine in this deck because of Ravine, but this one is a continuous Dragon Shrine pretty much if you keep pitching cards in your hand. And you know how important this pitch cards from your hand in this deck, because you gain advantage from pitching cards in your hand, which is the main theme of this deck. Just the 5 card engine for the field, and of course triple trading is the most live draw engine in this deck. And additionally, we play 1 Cards of Consonance as well. You can make this live, as I mentioned. You can search the level 1 Dragoonity, even if you don't have any of the blue eye stuff, because this is the more dead, because you have to draw the blue eye stuff, the blue eyes tuners, or the level 1 one of these ones. Or you can search it with Sage as well. So it's not the most live one compared to trading, because trading, even if you draw this mid game and you have the old egg, then you the new ancient egg in your graveyard, you can just banish it and get a blue eyes target from your grave, and you can draw 2 cards from trading. So just a draw engine, just the 4 card draw engine, still good, consistent and stuff. So we play triple Silver Scry. We're not getting like Mausoleum for a while, so for now we're playing maximum Silver Scry. It's quick play as well, so you can set it, and at the end phase you can flip it and get your Spirit Dragon or whatever and banish your opponent's back row, so it's very useful. I'll get the Blue Ice Monster to block some damage, that works as well. So triple Silver Scry is pretty good. Should play 3, and 1 Soul Charge. Turn 1 plays with this is busted, so just obviously play Soul Charge. Although you gotta watch out, if you got this on the field you can only summon 1, because that stops more than 2 monsters getting special at the same time. So you should play this before you summon this, or you can just watch out. If you only need 1, then it's not too bad. Turn 1 play with this is crazy if you got Ravine, so definitely play Soul Charge, just busted in this deck. Of course, just play 2 Twin Twisters, just get rid of back row. Discarding is good as well in this deck, so it works really well. And last but not least, one Raigeki, because I hate a Dark Lore Rafflesia and all that. A Rafflesia is quite annoying because you can bottomless your stuff, so. And then that's all the spells. Let's go to the traps. We play triple Horde Haunted. A bit unusual because we don't have that many back row in this deck, but Horde Haunted's clutch sometimes because you can resurrect your Spirit Dragon or your level 1 tuners from your grave. And also, we don't have Mausoleum. Mausoleum is quite important, which is out in July. So we're using this to resurrect stuff from the grave for now. This will do. It's one of the best ones that can resurrect with. It's a bit slow, but when we get Mausoleum, probably take these out for Mausoleum. But for now, this is one of the best ones we got. It's still good because it's a trap card. So there's a play where if your opponent blind MSTs this and you got one of these in your graveyard, you can just chain it and then resurrect it. And then it will die, obviously, and then at the end of the turn, you can spec a blue eyes from your deck because it's got sent to graveyard. So it just combos well because it's a quarter haunted. And you can also, similar to Silver Scry, bring back Spirit Dragon and then the white Spirit Dragon, the main deck one, to banish your back row. So just three quarter haunted, quite good. And one Karma Cut because I don't like indestructible stuff, and two Thing Blast for back row and also monsters. These targets, so against Cosmos, it's not very good, although you got a decent out to Dark Destroy and stuff anyway, and their new stuff, Dark Planet, you can kill it using, by crashing into it using Dark Matter. But Wind Blast is good against BAs and stuff, and sometimes Pendulums maybe, and Karma Cut just to banish the Dantes and whatever, to get rid of them. That's it, just all the traps, it's, I think it's 7 or 6 traps. Let's go to the extra deck very quickly. I did mention I do play Twin Burst Dragon, but I don't have it at the moment. But I will try to get one soon. And obviously we play the Spirit Dragon. Play two. Two is enough. You can also recycle it using the new egg. But I don't recommend doing that. But if you do need a third one, you can play three. But I rarely go to a third one anyway. And it's, the game's usually finished by then anyway. Keep in mind, if you bring this back using Call of the Haunted, you can't use the tag out effect where you summon one from your grave, from your extra deck. And because... it says when a synchro summon card is it only works if it's been synchro summoned, so it only works the first time you summon it, but you do still get the effect to stop cards from the grave, so you can Call the Haunted it back and then stop cards from the grave. So even if you have two of these with Call the Haunted, it's just ridiculous because you stop summoning cards in grave. Two Azorais, you just tag out into this most of the time and resurrect stuff, and it protects your cards as well, and it's good resurrecting the Spirit Dragons and stuff because you can banish back row. You play two because you can go to a second one, and if you have two of these, you've usually won the game because you can just resurrect two blue ice monsters and you can make a rank 8 obviously after that play. So 2-2 is pretty good. And the next target for this, you can summon only light dragon monsters, keep that in mind. And you got another target for this is Michael and Moonlight Rose Dragon. Michael's there for your turn. If you have this, you just want to banish something with Michael. It does something in defense position though. And you banish something with Michael, banish it by paying 1k. And this is for your opponent's turn. If you try to make an out to this, for example, a Utopia Lightning or whatever, some annoying monster that can kill this, and this, because usually tag out into this anyway, you can make a Black Rose Moonlight Dragon, which on play it will bounce back your opponent's monster. It will get destroyed the end phase, but it's fine because you'll banish your opponent's monster anyway. If you commit a lot of cards and into doing that play, then that's alright. You can also make this on your turn as well, offensively. And of course we play one Crystal Wing Synchro Dragon, one of the new cards. You know it's a win, you can't make it using this one, but you can make it using synchro plays by synchroing with these two. So that's why we play these, because so you combo is you can make this one banish, or you make this one bounce a card. And then with Ravine you can also search Dragoonity level 1 tuner, and then you can normal summon that one, and then you can synchro into Crystal Wing Synchro Dragon. So that's what the play you're going to do. It's quite useful. Negate monster's effects and gains the attack of it. So I think that's what it does. It gains the attack. Yep. And one Crystal Wing. When I get Twin Burst, I'll probably take out the Crystal Wing because this is the one that I make the least in the deck. But it's a good replacement. The last Synchro is just Gigantic Castle because it goes to 3-1, gets around monsters. Because it goes to, gains 200 attack for each non-tuner monsters used for it. Usually use, you always use one because you've only got thing. For the Dark Matter engine, we play one Tachyon, one Galaxy Eyes Flying Photon Dragon, one Armored Photon Dragon, because you can pop I can't. And it's also useful detaching the Blue Eye Spirit Dragon using this. And then obviously the Dark Matter, because it's just insane if you dump the three dragons from your deck. You can have so many plays, you can dump whatever you want. Keep in mind they have to be different names, and it's not really much a problem because you've got a lot of different dragon targets in your deck with different names. I think about 7 or 8 different names, and some of them are on multiples, obviously. So usually dump the new egg with this, but if you want to gain advantage, you can dump the old egg. And this one just pops cards. They're also very, very big monsters, 4,000 these. So I've been thinking of putting in Skill Drain as well instead of like a Karma Cup or something like that. So that might be a good tech to put in. I'm not testing that, but Skill Drain might be quite useful. Tachyon's just there, it's just good to add some other stuff, but you usually overlay into this anyway. But you should play two, because sometimes you do just go into Tachyon and then you don't even make this, you just go straight into Dark Matter. And so later on you can make this, it's 4k, and then you make that to pop a monster. So you should play 4 in the engine because it's just good. And we'll just play the last Titanic, last Galaxy monster. You can't overlay of this onto Dark Matter, but it's just a good Harbinger. You get spells, and if your opponent tries to attack your little dude, especially like a Sage or whatever, you can just make it attack this, and then that's it. I think it negates attack, it's Utopia or something like that. And the other rank is that we play is Divine Dragonrite, Velgrind, and Alsei. You can swap these. Velgrind is pretty much a must though, because late game, you can go into it and just sit on it and just keep on attacking. But Velgrind is quite useful. But you can take this out for a Heliopolis or another rank 8 like a Lancelot. It's just a choice, because this can actually remove cards in the field by just making rank 8. So if they got a back row they just want to get rid of, you just say you just call Soul Charge at the top of your deck, because if you don't draw Soul Charge you don't really care anyway, or Raigeki or whatever. And if it's usually the wrong card anyway, and he mills it, and you just top deck a top deck or bottom deck a card in the field. So just one Alsei. You can take that out for another rank 8, it's up to you. So yeah, that's the deck profile then. What do you think of that? I'll try to be getting the Twin Burst Dragon by this week, hopefully. It's quite expensive for some reason, but I don't know why, because you only play one and every build just plays 0 or 1, so I don't know why. It's probably because it's Blue Eyes, it looks nice, isn't it? So yeah, if you're building this deck, what do you think? I want to see your build as well, so yeah, what's your opinion and stuff? Alright, I'll be putting a deck profile thing on the on the website as well, so check that out. And you can also download the YGO Pro build of this deck down in the description below. So yeah, cheers guys, bye bye.